Good morning, Model Maniacs. Dirk here, getting ready to do that all-important kit review so that you, the model junkie, can get an informed decision on what kits you want to buy. Today, we're going to go back to 1988, I believe it is, with the USS Lionfish from Revell Models. This is a long one. I had to pull back the camera a bit. You can see it looks a little sloppy over here, but don't worry about that. But yeah, 1988, and we're looking at the Lionfish. The Lionfish was a World War II submarine. pretty cool. I don't know about you guys, but I like subs. I think they're really cool. Actually, nautical in general, as much as I don't build them, I really like them. And this is one of those kits. I've been dying to do a submarine, and man, this might be the one I start with. But let's take a look at what's here right now. The box itself comes in at 21 and a half inches long. That's a long sucker. It's about 7 inches tall, or wide, shall we say, and 2.5 inches deep. The box art here, kind of a semi-gloss, a little reflective, if you can see that in there. Okay, cover of the model built up. Okay, not a picture of the real thing or an artist rendition of the model. It's the actual model built up, sitting on a map. Pretty neat, actually, with some patches, naval patches, submarine hardware here, and a pair of spectacles over here. Looks pretty cool. Makes it look very nautical-like. The side of your box. Over here, we've got some specifications. Okay. Highly detailed deck, bridge, conning tower, twin propellers, deck gun, molded in gray, blah, 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 blah. Then you got some photographs of, close-up photographs, let's get in here, of the model itself that they did. Okay, pretty nice bow section. There's your conning tower. There's your stern section. Okay. And again, there's a length view of the ship from the stern. Very, very cool. The sides are just the same as the top of the box. Nothing really big there. And you got a little bit of history right here on the side. And that's really all there is to the box. Let's pop this sucker open and let's see what's inside. Okay, as we look inside the box, we got a little bit of paperwork. We've got a little bit of propaganda here from the model builder, special market headquarters. I guess fill out this survey and you can get a free model. Just don't select the option on here whether you're a citizen or not. You can get in trouble. Very racist. But not, just kidding. But yeah, just a little bit of a survey here and you have your chance to win a free model. I wonder if I should fill that out. What would happen with it? Anyway, next up is the instructions, but we're going to hold off on those until a little later. When we look at the kit, we've got two sprues of gray plastic. Two sprues come out to be about, I think it was about 39 parts I counted earlier. When I got this kit, you could see here actually how the box is all wrinkled. I got lucky and this kit was still factory shrink wrapped. Just over time, the cellophane shrunk, crushed the box a bit, but didn't hurt the contents inside. Then, of course, the box, the bag, the parts inside were in a bag. I removed those so we didn't have the crinkly on camera, and we can get right to the parts. So we got two sprues and about, what did I say, 39 parts, okay? Everything is in a light gray color, molded in light gray. The thing about some of these ships is that, you know, when it comes to the very, the detailed parts, the scopes and railings and stuff, not so much railings, but other little knickknacks here and there, they can be very, thick and gaudy. So, it's something to be aware of. It doesn't really make anything bad. It just, with a little effort, I think you can make the model look a little bit better, by, you know, maybe replacing some of these thick parts because they just look too thick to me. But let's take a look at each part and go from there. We'll make an adjustment here. Hang on one second. Okay, so here we are with the first sprue. We'll take a look at the parts best we can here. And again, it takes a little finagling because the parts tree is so big. But here we go. First, up here, again, these are parts I was just talking about a moment ago about being look a little thick to me. Again, you could probably get away with it, but they just seem so thick to me. And these are the guards that go back on the stern. I guess there's kind of like a protection against the propellers to keep the propellers from being damaged. Something might bounce into them and it would hit this rather than the propellers. If we look at the model right here, hold on. You could see them right there. That's them. Okay. So, like I said, they just look a little thick to me. Moving along, we've got down here, we've got some bow planes and dive planes, okay. We've got a machine gun. I forget what caliber machine gun it is, but that's your machine gun. You've got some of your periscope paraphernalia, one of the periscopes. Okay, again, more periscopes and antennas and such. Not too shabby there, actually. They look pretty good. Focus. There we go. How's that? Better. All right. We got some other parts here. Another deck gun. Some parts I'm not aware of yet. All right. Those might... I don't think those are guns. I think those are more like... or maybe they are. Yeah, these, I think, sit on each side of the conning tower. Another set of the pieces that I'm not sure they're supposed to look that thick. I don't know where these go off the top of my head, but they just look a little bit thick. All right. Parts up here, they might be searchlights. Can't tell. All right. Come down. There's your propellers. A little flashy, that can be cleaned up. Then we've got the front of the stand. It's very nice. It's got the these well-detailed pieces on it. All right. Then we've got the conning tower. Oops, hold on. All right. We got the conning tower there. Surprisingly to me, the rails don't look too bad. I mean, I've seen worse, but for this scale, they really don't look too bad. The panel lines are raised, which is always kind of a blah to me, but it does have, you can see a hatchway here. It does have rivet detail, so to sand this down and cut to rescribe the panel lines, I think I would just leave it the way it is. It doesn't seem like it's worth it. And hopefully, if you do a nice light coat of paint on here, enough to cover it, it won't get rid of that detail, because actually that's not too shabby. I kind of like it. Then we got our hull. Let me flip this around. Starting at the bow, you've got your torpedo tubes. You've got the holes here that are already cut, so you don't have to cut those and to add some detail. Okay. You've got your recesses for the dive planes. Now, if memory serves me, these here are all, should be holes, not just that. So if somebody wants to get detailed, they can cut those out. But it'd be a lot of work, but it would sure make the model look a lot better. Okay, and you can see your panel lines are raised on it. Okay. Sorry, having problems moving it so big. It's running into everything. Okay, you got your, I forget what they call these, the bilge keel, I think. Don't recall. I'll be corrected, I'm sure. All right, all the way down to the back end where you have your aft torpedo tubes. Okay, where your propeller shaft will go here. Okay, very nice. Very cool. And then the second sprue. Okay, our second sprue here has got the two parts. This is for the base where the sub actually sits on. And then you got that nice detailed piece I showed you earlier is the facade for it. The front makes it look really nice, but the sub will sit in here, cradled in there. You've got your rudder. This part is actually well done, I think. This is the deck. Okay, the teak decking on the sub. Okay, it's got some nice detail in it. You can see some hatches, equipment tie downs and stuff like that, where the guns go. I think they did a nice job and it looks pretty good. Okay, scroll down here to the other section. This is the aft section of the deck plating. Or decking. It's not really plating, it's wood. Okay, go down, 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 nicely detailed. If you paint this up, add a wash to it, these grids should hold a wash really nice and make it pop and look very nice. And then the last piece again is the hull, which is pretty much like the front part you saw before. We'll just get to it here. Okay, again, you can see a little flash in here, your torpedo tubes. I think it would be nice to cut these holes out here, make it look a lot better, I think. Okay. You can see what do they call them, bollards, to tie down the ship. Again, I was in the Air Force, not the Navy, but I do like Navy stuff, so sorry for not having the correct terminology. Okay, so that is the second half of the body. So that's pretty simple. Should be a really easy build for anyone that's looking to build this kit. And lastly, we have our instructions. Instructions are pretty simple. You've got a little bit of information here about the sub itself. It's class, it's a Gatto class sub and all that stuff. It's all good. It gives you your paint call outs down here, and then it starts with your first step, which is assembling the stand for it. Oops. You go inside and you've got five steps. You've got 6, 7, 8 steps altogether to build the ship. Or boat, I'm sorry. Very simple. I mean, it's not hard to do. And then the last step is your decal placement. And that's really it. And of course, something like this, there's not a lot of decals. Here's the decal sheet. It's not in a bag or anything, so it really wasn't protected. It wasn't in the bag because the instructions weren't in the bag that the parts were in. But you can see here the decals. I don't believe the decals in the case of what I'm going to do will be needed, but these are the decals. I'm not sure how well they can be saved. They're kind of dirty on top of being yellowed. I'm really not sure. You could probably put some decal bonder on there, but again, the dirt is what's kind of throwing me off with them. But I'm sure there's aftermarket places you can get decals, or you can just go out and make your own. I don't think it's that difficult. Oh, look at this. Just another piece of paper, and it's got all the flags, so you can put your, if you want to do the guide wires on it, you can put up some flags, send a message to somebody. Very cool. Very cool. So that is our kit review for the USS Lionfish, an old kit from 1988. Sub kits are not very readily available, if you ask me. I don't know, it's hard to say. Hey, if you want to build a German U-boat, there's plenty of those, but everything else, kind of sparse. So I have seen this kit out there. It's all kinds of price ranges, 20 some odd dollars on up, I guess. You just have to hunt and peck for them to find them, but they are out there. Like I said, they're just not a whole hell of a lot of them choices, and I don't think anybody does a modern day or a more modern I don't remember the last time this was reissued, so I can't tell you that in 2011 this was reissued again. I don't believe it was. That's what I'm getting at. I think the last time it was issued was in 1988. And like I said, they're out there, it's just they're not prevalent. So anyway, I'm contradicting myself and sound like a tool, but I hope this helped. I hope next time you see one, if you get the urge to want to build a sub and you come across this one and you're not sure what it's going to be like on the inside, if you want to spend your hard-earned money on it, that you can refer back to this video and then have a better idea and make an informed decision on whether you want to buy this kit or not. Till next time, guys, this is Dirk saying, be strong.